Welcome back to the show. What I got going on here today is a snowblower. My daughter has a friend I've known since she was like maybe 7-8 years old. And this snowblower is from her house. It looks like a pretty good snowblower, like a brand new snowblower. Says Craftsman on it, so I guess that's Sears. And the story is, it just won't start. So I'm going to take you through and see if I can figure this out. Now I'm going to put this on the Bruce Pender lift, and we'll get to it. But first, I just like to show all my new subscribers how I keep my shop. Like, it's cold outside today. Like, I mean, it's real cold. And I keep my shop nice and heated up. And I'll show you what I use. And I'll just get you down here. Oh, easy now, easy. Okay, there it is right there. That's what I'm using right there in my shop. Okay, there we go right there. Now, easy. Whoa, easy now. Okay, I got these great big clodhopper boots on because it's still cold on the feet. But I'll show you something here. This is 215,000 BTU. When I turn this on, it'll bring this shop from minus 15 Celsius up to 80 degrees in about 10 minutes tops. Fantastic heater, burns diesel fuel. My buddy Chase, 5726 there, he tried out a new one like this. But it's called Silent Drive. What a pile of crap that was. It was leaking all over, shoots flames out the front, does all kinds of problems. And he did a vid on it. And I'm going to put a link down the bottom there for that. And the second part will be out by the time this vid comes out on whether he gets it fixed or not. But this Silent Drive stuff, I'm not sold on it. I don't like the idea of having flames coming out the front here. But yeah, so let's get to it. And this is what I use to heat my place during the winter time. And I would say when I'm out here in the shop for say 4 or 5 hours, I'll have this on about, it'll cycle off and on about every half hour for about maybe 5-7 minutes. And that's pretty fuel efficient. I would say in the whole winter, I'm burning 15 gallons of fuel. That's about it. So that's not too bad. And we'll get to the repair right now. So let's see what we can do, and we'll stick the snowblower up on the Bruce Pender lift. Okay guys, this is the snowblower. Looks pretty new to me. I just put it up on the lift here. And I don't know even what kind of engine this is yet. But all I got was that it will not start. And, okay. So, I don't know what else is going on here. Apparently it's only a year or two old. Wow, they didn't even take this plastic off the rod here. And this seems to be loose. I don't know where the bolts is for that or anything. But somebody's been here. So, I don't know. The first thing I'm going to do is, let me see my little light here. I got this light at Princess Auto. Man, I can you believe that? Like, this thing was like $1.88 for this little LED light. You know, I mean, wow, I can't get over that. That was a good deal. So the first thing I'm going to do is, let's just see if this thing's got any oil in it. I don't know if you guys can see that or not, but yeah, it's got some oil in it. Help if I put the camera in the right spot. But yeah, it's got oil in it. That's the first thing I do, because I don't like touching anybody's machinery unless it's got oil first, because you never know, they run out of oil or they don't put enough in. Next thing you know, you seized it up. Here's the fuel tank. And I asked them if there was fuel. And see if I can get in there with the shot there. Guys, I don't know if you could see or not, but I'm not seeing no fuel, guys. Let me see there. Oh, I'm not seeing no fuel at all. Okay, Well, I hope that's not the problem. No fuel. Okay, because, you know, we went over there with the truck and picked it up and everything else. And I told them, does it have any fuel in it? And they said, oh, yeah, it's got fuel. Okay, so let me put some fuel in this thing first before I even start. Because I'd be dying if this thing doesn't, it's because it's got no fuel. So let me get back to you when I get some fuel in this thing. Okay, guys, let's put some fuel in this thing. I don't think it's going to be that easy, but I mean, I asked, does the thing have fuel in it? Oh yeah, it's got lots of gas. Well, I didn't see nothing in the bottom there, to tell you the truth. And I'll put some gas in there. You think I can pour that without making a mess? No way. Get a rag here, wipe this up. It's not the gas that goes on fire most of the time, it's usually the fumes. Okay, there we go. Okay, now it's got an electric start on it. So let's, let me get a cord. I'll get set up a bit here, and then I'll see if this thing's gonna go. Okay, guys, looking at the control panel here, and all it's got is a lever down here for choke. This is run, so there's the choke on there, and that was on the fastest speed. This is stop, just put it about halfway. This is the primer. I don't think I can really see anything that's wrong here. Oh, as soon as I touched it, I don't know if you've seen that, fuel come out right away. Now, usually I'm not noticing that before, like that much fuel. Whoa, boy, oh boy. Yeah, like that was a lot of fuel. And to me, that came out the float bowl. Let me just take another look here. See if I can take a look here. Let me just prime that a bit more now. Looks like there's actually a hole in the chamber there, but it's leaking a lot more fuel than I'd like to see. I'll take you off the stand here and I'll show you what I'm looking at, because I never seen this before. You guys take a look, see what you think. I'll bring this little LED light with me. Okay. There we are there. See if this thing's going to focus in at all. There we are. And that's awful muddy looking fuel, isn't it? And there's a... see if I can get up in there. See if I can get the light just right. You see that off to your left there? There's like a hole there. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put the light here, because something is definitely not right here. Let's see if I can unzoom here, because I think I'm zoomed in way too much and I'm up close. There. Now you watch when I press the primer. See the fuel coming out of there? I'm just touching it and the fuel's coming out. Okay, so now it's not. But I don't know what that deal is. Usually it'll come right out the front of the carburetor and down, but maybe this is something different. Yeah, you can see it coming out there. Yeah, that's strange. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'll clean up that fuel, turn it on and see what happens. Because to me, that don't look normal to me.
And I'm just wondering whether this gas fuel tank has been dripping down through that hole there. I don't know what that is. But to me, I think you're pressurizing the fuel bowl like every other one. And then it comes out the front of the car. But this one here might have a hole drilled there just for that. Yeah. So, let me put you back up on the stand here.
Okay, guys. So I think what I'll do is I'll fire it up here and we'll see what happens. Well, it sounds like it wants to do something. Let me just make sure everything looks okay. So the run's up here and the choke's on. Let me just try a little bit of choke off. Like running without the choke on. Just let her warm up a bit here. Shuts right off when you try to give it some choke. First of all, it was out of fuel. I'm going to double check, make sure I got enough fuel in there. And open up the garage door for a while, get the fumes out. And we'll get back to you. Okay guys, what I did was, you can see there I took the screw out of the float bowl. And there should be fuel just pouring down there. And it's not. So that tells me that the owner's more likely left fuel in the engine, like a lot of people do, didn't run it dry, and that ethanol fuel is stopping the needle valve from coming down on the float to let more fuel in there. That's why she'd run for a bit only on the choke. So I'm going to take that off. And we're going to take a look. Now, the only thing I don't like about this engine, I don't know who makes this engine, but they brought me over the owner's manual here. Here's the little set screw, that little screw that goes in the bottom of the float bowl. And they brought me over the owner's manual, and this is a Sears. And this is what I don't like about Sears. I don't know what engine this is. It doesn't say what engine it is. It just says it's a Craftsman deal. I don't know. But I'm going to take the bottom of that bowl off and then we'll take a look. The only thing I don't like is there's no fuel shut off on this, so I'm going to have to get a pair of pliers or something and crimp that fuel line off. So let me just take that off first and then we'll take a look. Okay guys, this is what I got here. And yeah, just like I suspected, there it is there. Now, you can see how it's all kind of gummed up on there. You could see the green crusties. So this has been in there for a while. You know, it's all slimy from the ethanol fuel. I'm going to spray some carb cleaner up in there, clean this all up, put it all back together, and I think it should be fine. I don't think I have to take the carb off. But yeah, I had to use my little needle-nose pliers there. Usually when you take the pin out, it'll just drop down. No, this thing was froze right in there. So let me get back to you when I got this all cleaned up and put everything back together. Okay guys, I put the float bowl back on and cleaned out the float. And guys, I had to use, I'll show you here, I just had to use a little X-Acto knife here. Because it was crusted on there so bad. It was almost like an electrical type of corrosion. And this is all from the fuel. Now, I looked in the manual. I don't know what kind of engine this is. I think it's a knockoff of some sort. But they all say in the manual, use regular 87, up to 10% ethanol. And I've seen so many problems. You've probably seen a lot of small engine channels where they talk about the fuel. And this is just testimony. Like, I mean, I phoned the customer. This is the friend of my daughter's. And I said, how come it's got no fuel in it? And they said, well, we drained it out so you could transport it. And I'm thinking, how did they drain it out? I mean, there's no fuel shut off on this. I don't know what the deal is on this, but yeah, it was pretty sludged up. And I see this all the time. Like, there's no shut off on this. If you want to store it, I always use fuel stabilizer. And for me, I use Seafoam. That's the only thing I use Seafoam for, is for a fuel stabilizer. I don't buy that Stabil and all the other stuff. I've had good success with Seafoam. And there's no shut-off valve on this. And I think that's part of the problem, is they put fuel in it and left it for the whole summer, and now they try to use it and it won't work. So, okay, so let's just give this a shot and we'll see. I didn't do anything else to it. I didn't even prime it. So I might have to prime it again. All I did was I took the vice grips off the fuel line just to let the fuel flow. And we'll see if she'll fire up. I got the choke left on, and I'll just turn it to about halfway here, I guess. And we'll see what she does. Okay. Maybe I'll take the choke. Actually, I had it on the run. I didn't have it on the choke. Okay, there we go. Yeah, she does not want to run unless it's got the choke on. So let's see here. Doing is I was giving it the primer and she was running, so that tells me that that it's starving for fuel. So what I might try next is I'll put some Stabil right inside the tank, because this job here looks like it's going to be like an hour and a half taking this carburetor apart, and I'd rather just try putting some Seafoam in there and see if that will unclog it, because I'm sure one of them passages in there are plugged. I looked at the float valve and it's going up and down okay now, but it's starving for fuel for another reason. So let me put some Stabil in there and I'll get back to you. Okay, I noticed I call it Stabil. No, it's not Stabil, it's Seafoam. This is an old Stabil container and this is what I use. Well, of course I got to mark everything, guys, so there you can see for yourself, you know. So I'll just put some in here. I'm going to probably put like... we'll go with, say, an ounce and a half. And I think I've got about maybe an inch of fuel in the bottom there. And we'll see if I just can't run some of that through it there and get her unplugged. So what I might try is just leaving her on. Instead of the choke being on, I'll leave it right on the choke off, but I'll use the primer bulb. That's a lot of priming to keep it going. Yeah, and if I put it up too high, she doesn't seem to want to run. Yeah, guys, she doesn't want to run on her own here. I'm going to double check that fuel line and make sure that there's no crimp. But the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take the drain nut off of the fuel tank again with the line not crimped and see how much fuel is going in there. Because if I'm getting good fuel flow now, then that means that it's plugged in the carburetor. It's not the float valve. And we'll see how we come up with that. Stay tuned. Okay, guys, I don't know if you can hear me or not, but I've had this running for about maybe a half an hour. I went in the house, just let it run for a while. So I've got like maybe 3 ounces of Seafoam in there with maybe 20 ounces, 25 ounces of fuel. And I can hear it starting to chug now when the choke is on. So I'll bring you over a little closer here so you can see. And I'll just zoom you in a bit there. So guys, I got it on half choking. She's got it on half choking and it's running. So there it is, guys. She's running without the choke on after half an hour of me throwing in that Seafoam. I'll put her wide open here for you. See, if I try to put the choke on, it'll kill it like it should be. There you go. Okay, guys, well, that's not too bad of a job. Little bit of Seafoam. Now, most of the time, guys, I'm saying Seafoam is going to fix everything. In this particular situation, the fuel had gelled to just before when it starts to really get sludged up. This would have never worked if it was really, really sludged up. This particular case, I went in the garage. I threw some Seafoam in it, went back in the house. And half an hour later, I start turning it slowly up to taking the choke off, and I knew it was starting to work. So it worked in this particular case. She's going to be glad that she got a snowblower. We're supposed to get about 10 inches of snow. So she'll be glad to get her snowblower back and it's running. I'm going to tell her, look, no more of that regular gas. Just put the super stuff in it. And what I do in all my fuel, I like to put 1 ounce of Seafoam for every gallon of gas. And I really don't know if it does any good, guys, tell you the truth. But I've been doing it for years and years, and I know I don't run into these problems. I've never run into a problem with this sludge stuff, you know, unless you're running the regular fuel. So thanks for dropping in, guys. Come back again. Let's have some fun. Bye now.